looking at all these given tables, you'll be able to quickly figure out the reaction order by just knowing a few tricks. Hello everyone, I'm Melissa Maribel, your personal tutor, and here are the tricks. Trick 1, zero order. If you increase the concentration of the reactant, but the rate does not change, then it's zero order. Trick 2, first order. If whatever you multiplied by your reactant's concentration is the same number you multiplied by the rate, then it's first order. Trick 3, second order. If whatever you multiplied by your reactant's concentration is the same number but squared to your rate, then it's second order. Here are some examples. We are multiplying by 2 here, and for the rate, we are multiplying by 4, since 2 squared is 4. Or in this table, where we are multiplying by 3, then multiplying the rate by 9, since 3 squared is 9. So right there, both of those examples are second order. All these tricks tell us the reaction order. Let's put this all together to find the rate law. For this table, we found reactant A was first order because we multiplied both by 4. So using the rate law formula, we will replace X with 1 since X and Y represent the reaction order for each reactant. For reactant B, we found it was second order since we multiplied by 2 and then the rate by 4. So we will replace the Y with a 2, and this is our rate law. Now you still have to know how to figure out your rate constant. I have a few videos with step-by-step examples that you can watch right over there. All right guys, I'll see you over there.